Navigating the markets might seem dangerous. Sometimes it feels as though it's a jungle out there. Hello, I'm Niranjan and I am going to give you the market outlook. But before doing so, I am going to take you back in time to show you the events that have shaped the markets and what we can look forward. This is the year 2000. What had happened? The end of the millennium. And the post Y2K scenario, the world didn't end. Computers were still running. And in the meanwhile, the index hit a fresh new high of 1750. But then the dot-com bubble was dead. And within 18 months, the index had lost nearly 50% in value and settled down at 870. I now move you to the next event. This was the year 2008. We came off a very strong 2007. The index had hit a fresh high of 6,300. But from there on, the global liquidity crunch had started and things weren't really as rosy as they looked. We went into a complete liquidity crisis. The entire world was in trouble. And within 9 months, the index had lost nearly 60% in value and hit 2,500. I now move you to the next event. This was the Eurozone crisis between the years 2011 and 2013. What had happened? After the global crisis of 2008, the Eurozone also had printed a lot of money, but unfortunately, that printing of money was not enough for them to move them out of recession. Their economies continued to flounder, and in fact, a lot of the economies in the Eurozone were expected to go out. There was even talks that the Euro might cease to exist. Grexit was the flavor of the season. People really had lost a lot of hope. During all this time, what had happened in India? From 1995, from a GDP of $360 billion, we have continued to grow to $2.65 trillion as on date. We have been averaging 6% annually, and today we are adding an equivalent of New Zealand's GDP every year. That's about $180 billion. And now, take a look at the journey of the index. From 1995 to 2019. And now look at all these events in perspective. Your dot-com bubble in 2000, small note there. Your global meltdown in 2008, it did have an effect, but it is not. But looking at the bigger picture, it's not really that big. And look at the European crisis. All these events are actually just a footnote in the history. Now, let me juxtapose the Nifty and the GDP chart. This gives you a better picture. If you did see the reforms from 1997 to 2004, which the government had initiated, pushed the GDP three times. But then this party was stopped in 2008 because of the global meltdown. And the government then also stopped on the reform process, which explains the pause between 2010 and 2013 for the GDP of the country. But then they realized in 2013 that they have to reform, and they reinitiated the reforms in 2013, which the current government is now taking forward. Now, let me just show you the time taken for the index to go between every 1,000 points. The first 1,000 points took 9 years and 1 month. But then every subsequent 1,000 points came in relatively quick succession, with the exception between 2009 and 2013, where we did go, where our GDP didn't really grow that fast. An interesting point to note is the GDP increase and the time taken for the next level. So which we also you can see that has been with increasing subsequent reforms, the GDP chugs along. Now, which brings us to the way forward. The government has announced a very ambitious $5 trillion economy. But you know what? We can just look at first reaching 4 trillion, which looks easier to do at this current juncture. The Jam Trinity, which is the Jan Yojana, the Aadhaar, and the mobile. What does this entail for the layman? This will help them who constitute the lower half of the pyramid with a lot more cash and spur a lot more consumption. The other point would be, is the rationalization of GST by reduction of slabs, which is much in the offing. What will this do? It will increase the number of people into the tax net and also bring in further collections. An interesting point today to note is that the GST brings in about 1 lakh crores every month. The other reforms which will have a bearing on the way we go will be the IBC, which is the Indian Bankruptcy Code, which will help the banks who have lent to a lot of the ailing institutions recoup their money much faster. And the other bit is Make in India to spur more development in India and to ensure more manufacturing so that we don't import what we do. We don't need to import a lot of the items. Before I close, I'm going to leave you with this chart which shows the calendar year returns of the Nifty. What does this show? That out of the last 25 years of Nifty being recorded, there are just 7 negative instances of where Nifty has given negative returns. Bad years are always followed by mediocre years and then followed by one great year which compensates for the bad years. And the other thing to note is that investing through the bad years does pay off. And also do realize that crises come and go, but investing during the bad years reaps its rewards when the good years return. The key to investing success is staying put and staying invested. Thank you.